Gross, and this is my movie review on The Thing. So I'm here at the AMC Theater at the Newport on the Levee in Newport, Kentucky, and I just got out of watching The Thing, starring Mary Elizabeth Winstead and Joel Edgerton. Now, this movie, The Thing, I'm sure you've known that The Thing has been done at least now three times. It was done originally in 1951. Then again in 1982 by John Carpenter, and now again in the year 2011. And you can only do a movie so many times, right? This version of The Thing actually is a prequel to the 1982 version. And you won't know that unless you watch the movie from start to finish. When I say start to finish, I mean you have to stay and watch the entire end credits of the film. It'll make you want to go home and watch the 1982 John Carpenter version of the film. Make sure you stay and you watch everything. The film had great CGI effects. The film was very, very suspenseful. And I'm going to go ahead and put some trailer footage in here, and then I'll give you my final thought right afterwards.
Hours ago, we found something quite remarkable.
What'd they find?
There's a structure.
In Antarctica.
And a specimen.
Really?
Touching down.
This is Kate Lloyd's, Columbia Paleontology.
Let me show you why you flew 10,000 miles.
We estimate it's been here 100,000 years.
I'm going to take a tissue sample.
Do you really think that's a good idea?
Yes, I do. You, my friends, will all be immortalized as the people who made this discovery.
Did you hear that?
My God.
Somebody was attacked.
But it seems everyone is fine.
Either someone miraculously healed themselves, or someone is not who they say they are.
What was it doing to him?
It's imitating his cells. I think this thing copies its prey and then hides inside it.
What are you saying?
Not all of us are human. It could be any of us. We can't let this thing leave. If it makes it out of here, millions of people could die.
The movie was rated R. It's an hour and actually it's 106 minutes in length. It's rated R. I must admit, I was thinking, oh my God, it's another remake. This week we had Footloose come out, this came out, both of them are remakes, and I'm saying to myself, dear God, if I have to sit through another remake of another movie, I'm gonna pull my hair out. And as you can see, I have no hair. But long story short, this film was very surprising. It was suspenseful. It had the oomph factor that films should have nowadays. CGI effects on the film were very great. It was shot very magnificently. The backdrop that they used, against the snow, it looks great. The cast and characters that they had in the film, they were all great. I don't know what else I can say about this movie except that it was beyond my expectation. It was not something that I expected, and I was very pleasantly surprised. With that being said, I definitely would give this one more than likely a minus. Would I see it again? More than likely I would. And I'm going to go home and watch the 1982 version by John Carpenter so I can get the whole effect of watching The Thing, because as I mentioned, this movie is kind of a prequel God, I don't really want to say this, but I'm going to say it anyway. The end of the movie, okay, starts the beginning of the John Carpenter film. There, I said it. There's your spoiler, okay, if you want to call it a spoiler. Most people aren't going to go home and watch the original, or I'm sorry, most people aren't going to go home and watch the 1982 version of the movie, but I am. Again, you know, it's just, it gives you a feeling of fulfillment. So I'm going to go home and watch that. So that's it for me. If you got any questions for me about upcoming movies or reviews I've done in the past, send me an email to theragreview@gmail.com. That's theragreview@gmail.com. And I'll hit you back. So for the Rag Review and CNN's Eye Report, I'm Rajim Gross.